I'm Starborn. Remember, to be a star, you have to shine your own light, follow your own path, and not be afraid of the darkness, because that's when stars shine brightest. And I hope you hold that thought this week, because the title of our show tonight is Bust Up. And if you've been looking on our website, you would probably think that that simply means there's some sort of catastrophe headed your way. And it's not necessarily that a bust up would be a catastrophe, but it doesn't mean that it won't happen either. And that is because for the next 2 weeks, there is a strong conjunction of two of the malefic planets, and then they are opposing a third malefic planet. And so when planets are conjuncting, it compounds their strength and adds to their intensity. And those two planets are Mars, which is in Libra, the sign of partnership, and that can be a marriage or a business partnership or contracts or legal dealings, and it is conjuncting the exalted Saturn in Libra. So Saturn is the stronger planet, but Mars is in there stirring a lot of things up. It's not really happy in a peaceful sign like Libra. And Mars is at 21 degrees today, Saturn is at 24 degrees, and that simply means for the next 2 weeks, as Mars gets a lot closer, and in fact by next week it will be exactly conjunct Saturn, so the intensity will be at its highest point, and then it will continue, and by the 23rd, it will move out of Libra, that will be wonderful, and into Scorpio, where it rules that sign. So for right now, with those two planets, Mars and Saturn, conjuncting each other in Libra, there can be a lot of tension or pressure in any kind of partnership. And on top of that, those two planets are opposing Uranus, the third malefic planet, which rules rebellion and sudden change, in Aries, the sign of new beginnings. So a bust up could occur if a new beginning is suddenly terminated, or it could occur because there's a lot of pressure, jealousy, and tension on people who have been partners for a while, or it can simply be that a legal matter that had been going on and on and on for a very long time, perhaps something from your past, for instance, finally can reach some sort of resolution, and that can create a bust up because of a final legal decision. On top of that, there are actually five planets in cardinal signs, not just the three that are strongly opposing each other, but in fact, Venus has now gone into Cancer. So Mars and Saturn are squaring Venus in Cancer, as well as opposing Uranus in Aries. And then Pluto in Capricorn is being squared by those planets, and Pluto is opposing that Venus in Cancer. So there is a grand cross among cardinal signs, meaning that it's very difficult to reach consensus, that people all think they are right, and so no one is in agreement about their values, and that can lead to a bust up right now. So you have to be really careful. This is not the time to lose your temper in any way. And if you feel like being critical of somebody, I hope you sort of step back and hold your breath right now, because it isn't going to get you anywhere except in a lot of hot water. However, there are three retrograde planets right now, and so that simply means that with the three retrograde planets, you might be better off by spending the rest of this month trying to finish up things or tie up loose ends in one way or another. In other words, backtrack a little bit. You might be on safer ground that way. However, if a bust up does occur in your life somewhere, and it could occur because of a change in management or downsizing or a change in rules and regulations, that simply means that everyone still will have some sort of option or opportunity. And the reason why is that even despite a bust up, there are seven planets spread out in the heavens among six consecutive signs. And that leaves options open for everyone. And so Neptune is in Pisces, it's retrograde. Uranus is in Aries, also retrograde. An exalted moon is in Taurus today. Jupiter is in Gemini, Venus is in Cancer, and the Sun and Mercury are in Leo, and yesterday Mercury went direct. So there can be all kinds of good ideas and options for change. Regardless of the reason for the change, you still will be able to sort of turn around and look for movement in new directions, no matter what happens in the next 2 weeks, while the pressure is so intense on partnerships. And so that is to the good. Right now, it's particularly important that you realize a lot of people have their money on practical matter, or their minds on practical matters and on money. And that is because that exalted moon in Taurus today is trining Pluto, a planet of power and truth, in Capricorn. Capricorn rules long-term security such as pension plans and retirement funds. And because Pluto is going retrograde, it means that policies can be redone, or there is the possibility that long-term assets have been diminished. They're not worth as much anymore. And for that reason, you may want to reallocate your assets, perhaps even sell a few things in order to, in anticipation of higher costs in the future. The one thing that is a little bit sad is that no one understands that you can go through a recession for 6 months before anybody tells you you're in it. And so why wait? If the part of the world is in recession now, there is the possibility that can spill over into areas of America's industry. And if you're involved in any way, maybe either as an investor or as an employee, maybe you need to look at your assets and redo them a little bit right now in anticipation of either higher costs or higher taxes. And so even if there is a bust up, who would be the eventual winner? That would be the person who has very high standards, somebody who has a good track record and great credentials and an awful lot of experience. Even if they suffer a bust up right now, they will be able to weather the storm. And that is because Jupiter in Gemini is trining that Mars and that Saturn, and it is the Saturn that is going to survive. It's the Mars that's creating the problem. Okay, what does this idea of bust up mean to all 12 of the sun signs? Well, Aries, I think you're going to be directly involved in some sort of a bust up anytime in the next 2 weeks. It would be irrevocable. In other words, you know, no second chances. It would simply involve something that may not even be in your control at all, Aries. And that is because all of the planets that are in the cardinal signs, harshly squaring and opposing each other, are going to remain that way throughout the whole 2 weeks. And so I think that the pressure will build, particularly by next week, when both Mars and Saturn are at the same degree in Libra, and they are opposing your sun where you have Uranus, and something's going to have to give. Now, remember what I said, Aries? Everyone will have options anyway. And so what I think might happen to you due to a legal decision that may go against you, or perhaps some downsizing, in other words, maybe the budget has to be cut, or it can be that a family member wants to have things their way so you don't get them your way, or it can simply be that some sort of new start of yours is terminated right now, and that could be due to all kinds of legal reasons. In other words, it may not be your fault, but it could still happen. And that could involve a contract that is nullified now or canceled. And so I think, Aries, you will be involved in some sort of a bust up. And when that happens, luckily, Uranus in your sign is trining the Sun and Mercury, which is now direct in Leo. It went direct yesterday. And so somebody with a great leadership idea could really be catching your attention sometime in the next 2 weeks. And I think you're going to be able to turn right around and join them and probably really like what you're doing. You know, you could like something new a whole lot better than what you're doing now, Aries. Okay, what does it mean to a Taurus? Well, Taurus, the moon is exalted in your sign today, and it's being trined by Pluto in Capricorn, which is retrograde right now. So there is the possibility, Taurus, that there can be a diminished value to your long-term assets and that you will need to reallocate some investments of yours, or what I suggest is that you sell them so that you can have some ready cash on hand, particularly by this fall when you can anticipate higher costs or higher taxes. In other words, if the value of something diminishes due to recessionary pressures, but you have a fixed cost regarding that asset, you're going to have to keep paying a high price for something that isn't worth quite as much anymore. And that kind of commitment can be very hard on your budget, Taurus. So this is a time, since I know you like to provide well for yourself and for your loved ones, when you really are going to need some liquid assets in order to escape the kind of financial pressure that can be on everyone, either through higher taxes or higher costs. And the reason why I'm cautioning you to liquidate assets now is because they are of a certain value. You do not want to wait until they diminish and you won't get your price. And that is why I think you should try to liquidate something right now. And if that means downsizing in order to preserve your wallet a little bit and keep it healthy, then I think that's a good idea. Okay, what does it mean to a Gemini? Well, Gemini, your sign is right in the middle of these six signs that have seven planets in them, and you have Jupiter in your sun sign. And so, oddly enough, Gemini, you would perhaps benefit from a bust up right now. Not necessarily one that could be happening to you, but actually Mars and Saturn and Libra are trining your sun, and where you have Jupiter, and so the pressure that those planets are creating among the cardinal signs does indicate the possibility of a bust up sometime in the next 2 weeks. But if that happens, since they're trining your sun, that could leave an opening for you somewhere. What if it happened to you, Gemini? You know, you might be delighted with that. And because that would leave you other options to explore. And you could have the possibility of expanding in one way or another, since Jupiter is in your sun sign, and that is a planet of expansion. So instead of just concentrating on one thing, if something happens to that, that might free up your time so that you can concentrate on two things. And you would love that, Gemini, because yours is the sign of duality. So believe me, everyone is going to have options. And I think you're going to have perhaps more than most, Gemini. So I wouldn't worry if a bust up occurs. I think there are better things ahead for you. Okay, what does it mean to a Cancer? Well, Cancer, with Venus in your sign for many, many months to come, I think that you can be very happy at home or pleased with the way your family members are resolving their own problems. So I suggest that you stay at home, Cancer, because there are a lot of problems among the cardinal signs right now, and you could be absolutely overpowered if you try to put any kind of pressure on anyone, because they'll push you back a lot harder than you're pushing them, and you could regret that. And the reason why is that with Venus in your sign, you just want everybody to be happy. You could also want everything your own way. And since Venus will be in your sign throughout the rest of the year, I think that you need to be a little bit more considerate of others if you can be. Cancer, and that would be hard to do right now because Mars and Saturn in Libra are squaring your sun harshly, which means that someone else is changing their mind and you might get a nasty surprise because someone does not want to go along with the way you want to do things, and they could even sue you if they want to right now. And you would not win that, even though you could deserve a lot of sympathy. You still wouldn't win a lawsuit right now. And also Pluto, Uranus in Aries is squaring your sun. And remember I said these planets are going to stay in the same position during these next few weeks while there is so much pressure among the malefic planets, and they're all squaring your sun sign. But Pluto in Capricorn is opposing your sun sign right now where you have Venus, and that means somebody is going to want to make a power play on you, Cancer. Oddly enough, I don't think that they are going to win that. In other words, if they try to overpower you and change the rules and regulations and tell you what to do, I don't think they're going to get away with it, Cancer, because you do deserve sympathy and you are in a good mood. You're not out to hurt anybody. But I don't see you profiting right now. Neptune in Pisces is trining your sun where you have Venus, so you have rose-colored glasses on and want the best for everybody. But that is not the mood the world is in right now, Cancer, and that's why I urge you to stay home and count your blessings, which all revolve around your family and your home. Even if they're little blessings, they'll add up. And so that's what you need to concentrate on right now. And if you need to crawl into your shell a little bit, Cancer, it would be very comfortable, and this would be exactly the right time to do that, because I don't think you want to bust up, but others do. And that's why you need to sort of stay away from people right now, because they could trigger some sort of nasty challenge, and that would make you very unhappy. So you just need to sort of bury your head in the sand right now. Okay, what does it mean to a Leo? Well, Leo, this is a time when I think that you can be full of good ideas, which you have taken the time to go ahead and polish up in one way or another. And that's because Mercury is now direct in your sign. If there is a bust up right now or in the next 2 weeks, I think you're going to be in a position to take advantage of it. And that is because Mars and Saturn are sextiling your sun, representing opportunities, particularly if there's some partnership or contract that changes drastically. And also Uranus in Aries is trining your sun, which means that if a new beginning is terminated, you might be able to take advantage of presenting your own good ideas, and people could be willing to listen to them. Would there be any extra money in your pocket right now, Leo? No, I don't think so, but you have to have a good idea first. And right now, the exalted moon in Taurus is squaring your sun, and that simply means that even though people can agree that you have some good leadership ideas and certainly a lot of good experience and are capable of whatever you are proposing, they are not too sure of how to pay for it all right now. So there can be an indecision regarding financing your idea. And I think that will pass, Leo. So try to have a lot of confidence and move forward anyway. And if there is a bust up somewhere around you, I think that's going to represent a sigh of relief for you and a chance to sort of take the lead. Good luck. Okay, what does it mean to a Virgo? Well, Virgo, this is a time when I think you are going to be able to see a bust up happen right in front of you, Virgo. And the reason why is that Mars and Saturn are closely conjunct in Libra, the sign ahead of yours. And so I think it's going to happen right ahead of you. Sometime in the next 2 weeks, either a coworker is going to experience some sort of a bust up, or there can be a group that you belong to that is breaking up in one way or another, or there can be a broken contract around somewhere. I don't think that it's necessarily happening to you at all, Virgo, but you are sure going to see it happen when it does. And it will be irrevocable. I mean, there's going to be no going back when that happens. And so I think for right now, you need to keep your mind on practical matters, because that exalted moon in Taurus is trining your sun, Virgo, and that simply means somebody who is financially secure or has their hands on some pretty good money is probably going to want to invest it in you, Virgo. And so I think that you're going to get a green light. If you're looking for a promotion, I think you'll get it. If you're looking for a raise, I think you'll get it. And that is because someone is deciding that you are really worth it and that you are trustworthy and bankable based on your reliable past record. At the same time, Pluto in Capricorn is trining your sun as well, and that simply means that you too need to look over your long-term assets, because I think the rules are changing. I don't think that they're changing enough to harm you, but you should still double check wherever your assets are and make sure that you can really afford them right now in the light of a possible recession that might be on the horizon. Okay, what does it mean to a Libra? Libra, yours is the sign that really might experience a bust up right now. Oddly enough, remember I said that everyone will have options? Well, you will too, Libra, and that is because Jupiter is in Gemini and it is trining your sun, so you might have two options or even more than that. But there is the possibility of a bust up right now, and that is because There can be a lot of pressure on you, Libra, to change your values. Maybe somebody wants you to lower your standards. You're not going to do that. Maybe somebody wants to put a lot of pressure on you and make trouble for you because they're jealous of you or envious, and you're not going to respond to that because Saturn is in your sign. It has been for a couple of years. You could be very close to the end of sort of a long journey that you've been on to complete a goal or a task. Maybe somebody is jealous of that and wants to disrupt you. And you're not going to stop, Libra. You're going to continue on. And so that can cause a bust up. The reason why, though, is because you are not going to be deterred from your high standards or your credibility. And certainly no one can take away your good track record or your years of experience. But people can be envious and jealous of that. And so there may be some people around that want to cause you trouble, Libra. And too bad. They'll just have to go on their way. So if a bust up occurs like that, you will certainly be able to weather the storm, and you could have increased possibilities for other options or opportunities as well, because for a whole year, Jupiter will be in Gemini trining your sun. So you need to hold fast. And just remember, if you hit rough water, your ship is not going to sink. You're very strong. So even if you win some sort of victory right now, you might be the only person left standing. That may not make you happy, but this is not a peaceful time in anybody's life. And so you simply have to adhere to your high standards and keep going, Libra. I know you will, and you'll be successful. Okay, what does it mean to a Scorpio? Well, Scorpio, this is simply a time when I think with Mars and Saturn in Libra right behind your sun sign, causing a lot of problems for people, that you simply are not going to want to continue a partnership or a legal contract that you may have been involved in. So I think it's the end of somebody in the background of your life, because I think you're going to refuse to go forward with them. Maybe it's time for that. Maybe something needs to dissolve right now, or a contract needs to be nullified. So I think you're going to be waving goodbye to somebody behind the scenes, Scorpio, and I don't think you're going to regret it at all. Okay, what does it mean to a Sagittarius? Well, Sagittarius, lucky you! You could have a wonderful opportunity in the blink of an eye to start something new. And that's because the planets are lining up in fire signs right now, and yours is one. And that is because Uranus in Aries is trining your sun. So even if one new beginning is terminated, there will probably be another. And the sun and Mercury are also trining your sun, and Mercury is now direct. So somebody who was a little fuzzy about their plans or their intentions has firmed them up now, and that could open the door for you. There could be a sudden opportunity to travel, and your sign does rule travel. And there can be a sudden opportunity to join a leader who is going to be able to go forward. Maybe the money isn't there yet, but the leader is. And I think that you need to have your bags packed, Sagittarius, and be ready to start in a new direction in an instant if you can. Okay, what does it mean to a Capricorn? Well, Capricorn, this is a time when you need to really be very, very careful. In fact, you need to sort of walk on eggshells for the whole rest of the month, Capricorn, and I'm not kidding. And the reason why is that, yes, Mars and Saturn in Libra are compounding their strength, which is intensifying now and can create a bust up because they are in Libra. Saturn is your ruler, and so both of those planets squaring your sun sign simply mean that other people are really wanting to take control, or they are wanting to be in charge of some sort of legal matter, and they can be challenging you, and they can be a little nasty about it. So you need to back off, Capricorn, and be really, really careful, because in the end, it's all going to be about the money anyway, and you're pretty good with details, Capricorn, but you do not need to engage with people who are combative right now, because you'll lose. And so that is why if you are critical about anything, you need to keep it to yourself, Capricorn, because you can resolve a troubled matter in the months to come. You don't need to do it right now. So I would avoid all people who are combative right now, because they could really harm you. On top of that, Uranus in Aries is also squaring your sun, and that means there can be sudden changes or a sudden termination of a new beginning, so that just as you were getting hopeful about something, that could be nullified as well. And so you need to be very careful about sudden accidents or sudden mishaps, and this is why you need to slow down, Capricorn. The slower you go, the safer you will be. On top of that, Venus has now come into Cancer and is opposing your sun sign, which means that other people involved with real estate matters or family members can deserve a lot of sympathy right now, and they don't want to talk about money. They just want to talk about what they wish they had, and that might leave you high and dry. So although you could be correct about something right now, in other words, the truth could be at your fingertips, nobody is willing to listen right now, Capricorn, and that's why you need to really be quiet, particularly for the next 2 weeks. Okay, what does it mean to an Aquarius? Well, Aquarius, this is simply a time when you can benefit from a bust up because the planets in Libra trine your sun, and so does Jupiter in Gemini. But you could be concerned about money instead, Aquarius, and I don't think it's there right now because the moon in Taurus is squaring your sun. So that is why, even though you can benefit from change, I think that you shouldn't change too much right now, Aquarius, because where are you going to get the money to pay for it? Go slow. Okay, what does it mean to a Pisces? Well, Pisces, this is simply a time when I think you can be delighted by the fact that Venus in Cancer is trining your sun. That means you can have a very happy home life, and you can enjoy the possibility of an upcoming move, which would be good. As far as some sudden change that could occur, yes, it could happen due to a bust up, but if it does, that can simply leave you an opportunity to jump into something new. All right, thanks so much. I'll see you next week right here for Starborn, and if you look at our website, starborninstitute.org, you can see the show any time of the day or night. Bye.